Ah, paper. A key player in the annals of history. Without it, humanity can never record knowledge in scriptures, allow for easily accessible literature, and provide for many other quintessential aspects of our daily lives. Without paper, amenities such as paper towels, tissues, cardboard, books, and newspapers wouldn't have existed. But to truly understand its importance and the numerous innovations it has undergone to become the paper we recognize today, we must go back to the origins of paper. Thank you very much.
Say it's only a paper moon sailing over a cardboard sea. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yes, it's only a canvas sky hanging over a muslin tree. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Without your love, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your love, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me.
Long, long ago, in a time where paper didn't exist, in order to write down really anything, people wrote on clay tablets, inscripted on stones, wooden signs and boards, animal pelts, and even leaves. Then, around 4,000 years ago, the Egyptians invented something that the world has never seen before. It was something called papyrus, and this was the first step towards paper as we know it today. This was done by weaving together reeds of papyrus plants, pounding them into thin, tough sheets that were easily written on. Papyrus was used for a long time, until paper as we know it today was made. Approximately 2,000 years ago, the Chinese made the first paper from a watery paste of mulberry bark, hemp, and cloth rags. By mixing these together and then straining out the excess water, they created large sheets of paper that was then left out in the sun to dry. Papermaking was an important Chinese trade, and they kept the method of papermaking a closely guarded secret for hundreds of years, until around 600 years later, when a Chinese paper mill was taken over by an invading army. Soon enough, paper spread throughout the Middle East, Africa, and Europe. Paper was now worldwide.
The first major innovation in paper was the ability to decrease the size of the fibers used. This came about 50 to 100 years after the invention and greatly increased the paper quality. This occurred because the metal tools that were used in paper making were now able to be made more precisely. This allowed fibers to become smaller. By the 8th century, paper had spread to the Middle East. Here, people were using mills and factories to produce pulp and paper. This slightly decreased the cost and helped it spread. By the 11th century, papermaking had spread to Europe, where it was being somewhat industrialized with the use of water-powered mills. This decreased the price even more. At this point, the paper being produced was similar to the paper today, but it still used cloth as the primary ingredient. By the 19th century, people started using wood pulp as a main ingredient in paper. This was caused by the major industrialization of the world. This allowed more refined machines to grind the pulp and press the paper, allowing for a finer pulp and thinner paper sheets.
Do you believe that paper is still a viable means of recording knowledge?
I think it is a viable means for the following reasons. If properly cared for and stored, it doesn't go out of date, power requirements never change, the file format won't be lost, you'll never need new or different hardware or software to read it with, it will exist in perpetuity, again, if you care for it properly.
How long do you think paper will be used as a main way of storing knowledge?
I mean, what are we talking, 5,000 years of use so far?
Yeah.
So if we look at the 5,000-year record of paper, that's going to continue to be stored. Even if it gets digitized, people will still keep the originals of some things. Gutenberg, Bible, right? I mean, I think you could tack another 5,000 years on there. there isn't one good device that can simulate all the benefits of paper for someone who's either not who's reading casually like on a Kindle, but I'm thinking more like taking notes and highlighting in a textbook. Yeah, there are apps that do it, but they sometimes are textbook specific. They're really clunky. There's a lag factor when you're using an iPad or an Android tablet to highlight on. People keep going back to paper because it's so accessible. And I think its accessibility hasn't been matched by technology yet.
Do you think the use and production of paper is more damaging to the environment than the use or production of computer hardware?
So that's an interesting question. What an outstanding question. So if you think about it, you can argue that paper is more easily renewed than many of the components that are used in producing a tablet that you could read that same text on, right? If paper is renewed sustainably, so you don't just clear cut a swath to make a million pages of blank white paper, but you are more careful in what you do, it seems like it could be more sustainable relative to the 5 to 7 year lifespan of the average piece of technology, and then that goes off to landfill / e-waste recycling. So I think paper might also win there. Now, what would be great is if we could find some alternatives to traditional materials, that is taking a tree and chopping that up. How much more can we get into recycling existing stuff to still make good paper? I don't know. The problem that paper faces that we haven't touched on, though, besides sustainability, is that paper takes up a ton of space. Walk into the National Archives of any country and they have millions of square feet to store paper. You and I know how much storage space that would take on a server. It would be like a decent sized closet. So there's another issue with paper, is its footprint is massive in terms of storage when you're trying to access it.
All right, okay, well, we can do questions. Okay, very good, first hand up.
Sir, as a company that primarily distributes paper, how have you adapted your business model to function in an increasingly paperless world?
We can't overestimate the value of computers. Yes, they are great for playing games and forwarding funny emails, but real business is done on paper, okay? Write that down.
Hello, my name is Mr. Neely. I am the Prince of Paper, the Pariah of Pulped Cotton, and the King of Cornell Notes, I guess.
What is your stance on paper versus technology in the modern era?
I think that they both serve a role in the process. I think that there are times where using electronic media is going to be the most effective way to get this across. There's certainly a time and a place where I think that putting a pencil to paper and going a more analog route would be appropriate as well. So, like I said, I think they're two different tools. They're two different technologies, and they both have application in education.
Do you believe paper still has a role in current education?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I think if you're trying to argue that we can go entirely paperless, you haven't thought very much about the issue. There's, as I said before in the previous question, pencil and paper is a technology, and it's a beautiful technology, and if you're using it when it's the most appropriate, then it has a time and a place. So I think students should probably be able to use both.
Do you believe a paperless education system is in the future?
Not entirely. I think a lot of people have kicked that idea around, but the aspect of going straight paperless is, there's a large number of unintended consequences which go along with that. And I think as we get further down that line, we're beginning to stumble across those unintended consequences. And we're not necessarily getting the results that we needed from going straight paperless. So I don't think you can really construct an effective educational environment which is strictly paperless, because there's something about the idea that we're going to write that information down which is kind of hardwired into our brain in the way that we remember. I mean, we've been drawing things and making, recording things with some type of, you know, media, be it charcoal or paint or something, since we've been living in caves. So that aspect us has been something that's been going on for quite some time, and I don't think 15 or 20 years of trying to go paperless is going to erase that.
Thank you so much.
You're very welcome. Thank you.
Despite the many benefits paper has provided to humanity, paper has also had numerous detrimental effects as well. While paper's value is in part due to its disposability and inexpensive costs, these same benefits allow for a mindset in where paper can be thrown away at a whim. The same mindset is what has allowed paper to take up a massive part of our landfills, accounting for 28% of all garbage thrown away, the largest single waste material found in municipal stream, according to the EPA. This same carelessness extends to the making of paper as well. Due to the massive demand for paper, the paper industry requires a large amount of wood to create paper, as shown by the statistic that 30% of all trees cut down are due to the paper industry, with 9% of these trees coming from old-growth forests, a particularly difficult-to-renew resource. Furthermore, paper mills expel significant amounts of air and water pollution, as well as toxic byproducts entering the water. While the benefits of paper are numerous, the formation and disposal of paper creates a significantly negative environmental impact, as well as a factor to the current environmental problems of today.
As we look at the world of today, we still use paper for all of the same reasons we have in previous years. But there's a new technology in town, the computer. People use computers arguably more than paper for writing now. Computers can store a nearly limitless amount of Word documents, way more than a room full of filing cabinets. So computers are better fitted for filing and business reasons, but what about everyday life? E-readers have gotten increasingly popular because of the limitless amount of storage and better holdability, plus the ability to read in the dark.
Paper is undoubtedly one of humanity's greatest achievements. Despite the increased use of technology causing paper to decrease in significance, it is still an essential part of humanity's history. Despite its simple purpose, paper has still undergone numerous beneficial innovations to become the mass-produced powerhouse it is today. While this has come with its fair share of environmental consequences and negative impacts, the monumental effect paper has had on the industry and the present day is extremely phenomenal and will continue to be an integral part of society.